Good morning, students. Today we are going to start a new chapter from the physics, that is matter. So we will start the chapter with the definition. So what is the definition of matter? Matter is what? Anything that has mass and that occupies space is called matter. That means the things having mass, having space. So a lot of examples might be there, right? So examples may be steel, may be wood, sand, ice, water, milk, all the different kinds of matter, even the chair on which you are studying, on which you are sitting, the sofas, a lot of the things that is surrounding you, that are the matter. So we use the word matter for all the things of universe, whether it is living or non-living. Now I'm using the word living. Living means to say even the human being. That means us, even the animals, these are also matter. Why? Because our body is made up of matter. Now if I'm saying the example from non-living, so a lot of there, it may be wood, as I said, steel, a lot of things are there, the chair, wood, chair, or you can say the glass, a lot of things are there. So now from where the thing is, that now definition is clear, but of which the matter is made up of. So matter is made up of very, very small particles called atom. So atom is what? I'm saying the word atom. So atom is what? It is the smallest particle of matter of which it is made up of. But thing is that atom do not exist independently in nature. So what happened? Atoms, they join together, to form what? Molecule, right? So molecule is what? Molecule is the smallest unit of matter that exists independently in nature. Now if I said what is the difference between atom and molecule, so difference will be, atom is what? Atom is the smallest particle of matter, but that do not exist independently. But molecules are what? These are the smallest unit of matter that exists independently, and also your molecules are made up of atom, right? That means your molecules combine together to form matter. They have all the properties of that matters, right? Now the things comes, a lot of molecules are there, but we can categorize the molecule depending upon the number of atoms, right? How? So depending upon the number of atom, we are having the categories monoatomic, then we are having diatomic, then we are having triatomic, right? And tetra, and then poly. Now first come to the monoatomic. So what are monoatomic? A molecule that has only one atom, right? What I'm saying, the molecule which is having only one atom is called monoatomic molecules, right? Example, if I come to the example, have you listened about the neon? What is its symbol? Ne. So this is what? Monoatomic. Another example is what? Argon. How we denote the argon? Right, this is also monoatomic, right? So monoatomic is what? A molecule that is having only one atom, right? That is called monoatomic molecule. Now next comes to the diatomic. Diatomic molecules are what? The molecules that are having two atoms, right? So if I am asking, if I ask the examples, so have you listened about oxygen? How we denote oxygen? O2. And also hydrogen. So hydrogen is what? Again we denote it by H2. So these two defines the number of atoms. So what we will say about the diatomic? The molecules that has two atoms, they are called diatomic molecules. And examples, hydrogen and the oxygens. Next comes to triatomic. Triatomic molecules are the molecules that has three atoms. Even from the word you can get to know that tri means to say three. So how much atoms will be there? Three atoms. So the molecules that has three atoms is called triatomic, and the examples will be water. So what is the symbol for water? It is H2O. That is, how much molecules are there? Hydrogen, two molecules, oxygen, one molecule. 2 plus 1 is how much? 3, right? So total number of molecules is how much? 3. So this is triatomic. Now if I say carbon, have you listened about carbon dioxide? So carbon dioxide is, what is the symbol? CO2. Now you are having carbon 1, O2, 2. 1 plus 2 is how much? 3. So total number of molecules is how much? 3. So this is what? Triatomic. Now next is your tetraatomic. Tetraatomic means to say, again tetra means to say 4. That means it is having 4 atoms, right? So tetraatomic molecules are the molecules that has 4 atoms. And if I say the example will be what? Phosphorus. What is the symbol for phosphorus? It is P4, right? This 4 denotes the number of molecules. Is it clear, bacha? What is monoatomic? What is diatomic? What are triatomic? What are tetraatomic? Now, the last is what? The last is polyatomic. Now, polyatomic means to say a molecule that has more than 4 atoms is called a polyatomic. What I am saying, it is having more than 4 atoms, right? A lot of examples are there. So I am writing the example. One of the example is sulfur. What is the notification? It is S8. So how much molecules are there? 8. So it is more than 4. So it is what? Polyatomic. That means just by having their chemical configuration, you can get to know either it is monoatomic, either it is diatomic, either it is triatomic, or either it is tetraatomic, and last, polyatomic. That means the molecules which are having more than 4 atoms is called polyatomic. Is it clear, students? So next comes the kinetic theory of matter, right? I will explain you this in the next video. Till then, please revise it.